Hello everyone, so welcome to my new video regarding Cannizzaro reaction. So I'll be discussing about the reaction in details along with examples. So first of all, let me make you understand the difference between aldol and Cannizzaro. So the basic difference is, which you must remember, is basic difference between aldol and Cannizzaro. I made a video on aldol already. So the basic difference between these two is that aldol has an alpha hydrogen while Cannizzaro does not have alpha hydrogen. Let me make you understand that what is an alpha hydrogen. If I take this compound CH3CH2COH for example, then this compound has an alpha hydrogen in this form. Alpha hydrogen means that if we have a carbonyl group and we have adjacent carbon to that, so this carbon should have hydrogen. Okay, so this is known as alpha hydrogen. One more example, CH3COH. We have a carbonyl group and adjacent carbon to that has hydrogens, so this is known as alpha hydrogen. Here this is known as alpha hydrogen. If we have HCOH, we have a carbonyl group, we have no carbon on the either sides, so this is having no alpha hydrogen. So this will give me the Cannizzaro reaction, while this will give aldol and this will give aldol. So this is the basic difference between aldol and Cannizzaro reaction, that alpha hydrogen is present or not. So let me do a question so that the reaction mechanism is clear. So if I take 2 moles of HCOH plus OH minus concentrated, I get a question mark. So this is the question, that HCOH is there, 2 moles, and I take OH minus concentrated. So see how to proceed. First of all, write the HCOH, OH minus. In aldol, the OH minus used to take out the most acidic hydrogen in the form of H plus, but here we do not have any alpha hydrogen. So what can OH minus do? The only work that OH minus can do is attack itself on the carbonyl group. So I'll be getting HCO minus H and OH. Okay, what can the next step be? See, okay, this is formed. The next step can be, this electron density on goes on this bond, which takes out the H minus. So what is happening actually is, this electron density comes here, so it means I'll be getting a double bond here. This electron density goes out with H, so this bond is removed to give me H minus. Okay, so I hope this is clear. So we get a H minus. We have taken only one mole yet, so we take the second mole. So HCOH, the second mole given, it attacks this to give me C. I'll be getting HCH. This electron density goes here, so O minus and H. So these are the basic two products that I'm getting yet. Okay, now let us see. So you need to tell me if HCOO minus is more stable or HCHHO minus is more stable. The first one is more stable. Why? Because it has resonance. Okay, the second one does not have any resonance. Okay, so this minus is here. The H plus comes from the acid to join this minus here, giving a minus charge. So the final product which I'll be getting are, this will be HCO O minus, and here I'll be getting CH3O. H. So these are the final products of this aldol condensation. Let me show you one more example that how to proceed on such type of questions. If I have the question as HCOOD, D means deuterium, OH minus concentrated question mark. See, again I do not have any alpha hydrogen here. So which reaction mechanism do we have to follow? The Cannizzaro mechanism. So 2 moles are given. Okay, So HCO D OH minus attacks here, I'll be getting HCO minus OH and D. Okay, the next step is to take out the H minus. So this goes here, takes out the H to give me C double bond O D OH plus H minus. Till now we have only used one mole of this. So the second mole is taken. So HCOD, this attacks here to give me HCH O minus and D. So these are the products that I am getting till now. What I have told you earlier that the minus charge here would be more stable than the minus charge here. So this bond breaks, H plus goes and joins with the O minus to finally give me D C double bond O O minus, and what I'll be getting here plus H C H O H and D. Okay, so this is how you have to proceed in the Cannizzaro reaction. Now let me go to the next case where we have intramolecular Cannizzaro reaction. So the question asked is HCO COH OH minus concentrated gives me question mark. So again, the carbonyl has a no adjacent carbon with hydrogen, so no alpha hydrogen is present. So we need to proceed by Cannizzaro mechanism. So the first step is that OH minus will be there, it will attack the carbonyl. So let us see what happens. So I'll be getting HCO CO minus OH and H. The next step is this electron density goes here, taking out the H minus to give me HCO C double bond O OH C plus H minus. Now the H minus taken out will be attacking the other carbonyl. So what it will, same mechanism is followed. So HCO minus H C double bond O OH. Till now I'm getting what we had already discussed here, that the minus charge is more stable here rather than here. So the H plus breaks from here to join here. So I'll be getting H C OH H C double bond O O minus. So this is the final product of this reaction. So you can see that how simple is it to do Cannizzaro reaction. Now the last example for the intramolecular is, if I have benzene C double bond O C double bond O H OH minus concentrated. So first of all, let's decide that where the OH minus will attack. OH minus is a nucleophile. So nucleophile attacks the position which has less crowding. So this carbonyl has more crowding because of benzene. This carbonyl has less crowding because of hydrogen. So the OH minus will attack here to give me benzene CO CO minus OH and H. Again the same steps, this will go here, take out the H minus to give me benzene CO C double bond O OH plus H minus. Now this H minus will attack the other carbonyl to give me benzene C O minus H CO OH. Okay, now this O minus is here, we know that this minus is more stable than this, so this H plus will attack here to give me benzene C OH H C double bond O O minus. So this is the final product formed. Okay, so if there are any doubts in this video, then you can definitely ask me in the comment section, and best of luck.